We'll be walking around the other way, remember?
Yeah,
they take you around that side.
Did you want to drop them? I thought she did.
No.
I turned around. I was about to be like, Kaylee, I told you to keep those in your pocket.
I had mine in the pocket the whole time. All I did was, Melissa, the only time I played with it was in the pocket and made sure.
Gather around me for a second so we can introduce the house. Everybody down there, come on over. All right, guys. Now, Andrew Lowe would come to Savannah as a young 17-year-old. He would come here to work for his uncle's hat merchant business. He would take that business over very shortly after. He would become very well-to-do in his own right. However, well-to-do Andrew, he would find very little happiness in this home. Before it was even completed, he would lose his first wife, Sarah Cecil Hunter, and their 4-year-old son. They would never even see the house. Now, he would marry 5 years later. He would marry Mary Cooper Stiles. She, unfortunately, would pass away in this house shortly after the birth of Andrew's 6th child. So because of that, as you can imagine, Andrew didn't want to spend a lot of time in this home. He found it very depressing. As a matter of fact, he would spend a great deal of time in his home in England. However, as you guys can see, it's very elegant and very opulent. Somebody had to be in charge of this home's upkeeping. Thomas A. Millage was that man. Now, although he was born a slave, there was no greater friend to Thomas than Andrew. As a matter of fact, in their years together, nobody garnered more respect from Thomas than, from Andrew than Thomas. He would actually leave him in his will the sum of $300 a year until he passed away. With inflation, that is about $8,000. However, sadly, Tom and Andrew would both pass away in 1886, about 2 months apart. It's not all sad though, because he actually left a clause in his will that the money went to Thomas's widow and their children. Now, because they were such good friends though, before Thomas passed away, Andrew did have a tombstone commissioned for him. It graces his headstone, it graces his gravesite at Laurel Grove Cemetery South. The inscription reads, "In affectionate memory of Thomas A. Millage, for many years the faithful friend and servant of Savannah of Andrew Lowe." Now, because of all this stuff, as you can see, Andrew really valued Thomas. He meant a great deal to him. Because of this, we attribute a lot of the activity that happens, especially on the lower floor of this home, to Thomas. There are a lot of reports of heavy, heavy footsteps. There are reports of doors opening and closing for no apparent reason. There are reports of talking in rooms with nobody in them. We believe all those stories are Thomas. Thomas wants to ensure that this home is getting the appreciation and respect that it has earned. Now, underneath, we're not going underneath, but I'm just going to tell you about it. That is the original servants' quarters and kitchen. The staff here nowadays, we use it as offices. That's where the archives are. However, even before this home was built, this was the original jail in Savannah. It was knocked down, but underneath the ground here, there are still catacombs, which means there are bodies still underneath this home. Also, does anybody know what a necropolis is?
A what?
A necropolis?
No.
That is a city of the dead. The reason we call Savannah a city of the dead is the 2-mile radius, especially around River Street, and all around it, there have been 14 mass graves unearthed. 14 of them. A lot from yellow fever epidemic, a lot from the Great Fire. So I just want everybody to keep in mind, as you are walking up and down River Street, you are probably walking on a dead body. If you're walking through this house, yep, they're still under there too. Sounds fun, doesn't it?
Let's go.
All right, guys. I want everybody to take a look right in that middle window, though, real quick. Tell me if you can see a little somebody sitting there.
Mm-hmm. That one?
Yep, yeah, the middle one right there.
Little something. And she's not very big, but she is sitting there. That, my friends, is a doll. That room right there, that is the nursery. You're going to see her when you go upstairs. But because we don't really have time to explain why she's sitting in that window, I'd like to tell everybody while we're out here. You see, there is a tea set sitting in the middle of that nursery. There are a bunch of dolls sitting around the tea set. She used to sit with them. However, One day, the Girl Scouts, they're in here, they're getting their course. She decides she doesn't want to play with the other dolls anymore. She actually gets up, takes a teacup with her. The Girl Scouts, as you can imagine, they freak out. They take off. We could not get them back in the house to do the tour. However, now we have placed her right there by the window. Oh. She is in timeout. She can't play well with any of the other dolls. All right, guys, I want you guys all to move a little forward because they got to get right back on their trolley. Uh-oh. We are going to be going in any second, but because of COVID, we can't have the two doors on the left. So, as soon as they get on, you go. Also, guys, anybody here interested in the Girl Scouts? Nobody here was a Girl Scout?
She said that.
That's my favorite. You were a Girl Scout? You might be interested to know. We're going to go to the courtyard, guys. When we go to the courtyard, if you turn back, there is a carriage house. That carriage house is where the first meeting for the Girl Scouts ever took place. All right, would you guys notice if somebody crept up on you?
Uh-huh.
I'd like to turn around.
Hello. Welcome to the Annalo House. My name is Katie. I'm one of the assistant caretakers tonight. It has been an active house, so please take your pictures. But especially be careful on the uneven sidewalks of historic Savannah. My theory is that there's bodies decomposing underneath all those dips. Let's head back to the courtyard and continue your adventure.
I had speed dead last night.
If you don't mind stepping to one side or the other of the courtyard, using me and the fountain here as a dividing line. Are they kicking you out?
Yeah, but you're welcome over here.
You got voted off the island.
Yeah. Weakest link.
Goodbye. Anyways, guys, it's just a little easier to move throughout the home in two separate groups, that's all. Well, that being said, I'm actually going to take you guys here. You're going to start with me. We're going to begin upstairs, and I'll tell y'all stories of the people who died in the hall. Doesn't that sound fun? Group here, you're going to be staying with your guide, starting a little parlor level. She'll tell you all the residual haunts of the hall. Doesn't that sound fun?
Oh.
But don't worry. We'll swap places. We'll hear a bell, so that's our signal. We'll hear the same things, see the same things. Now I know she has my back, told all the rules of the home, correct? I'm going to reiterate two of them just to elaborate on them a bit more. As we are going throughout, please try to stick with your group at all times. Also, do not lean on, sit, or touch any of these furnishings. Exception to that rule. One antique you are able to touch is the handrail as we're going up and downstairs. So please do use it. It is there for your safety. Both of them. One inside and one out here. Now, the other one is to take photos. Take as many as you like, quick succession, just no flash photography. If you have no idea how to turn off the flash, I see a youngin. Just hand it to her. I'm sure she'll figure it out for you. Other than that, guys, you're on a ghost tour. If you're not taking photos, you're not going to be able to capture a ghost. So go ahead and take them, especially while we talk, because once we're done, we will move on to another part of the hall. All that aside, my group, are you ready?
Yes.
Deadly. You can follow me.
Probably you dropped something. I guess not. Maybe it was a leaf that fell.
You ready, Bailey?
Yeah.
Yes, make sure as we're going in, you can wait for your feet on the bus. What is our hand taking?
You want to grab the handrail?
Right.
see her. Yes. Come on in, take all the pictures you want. Spread on out. Do I have everybody? All right, guys, welcome to the parlor of the Andrew Lowe home. Now, you are all standing in the presence of a very documented haunted item. Does anybody know what it is?
The mirror?
Nope. It is actually this beautiful pianoforte right over here in the corner. Now, that upright design, it is essentially a baby grand piano. It uses the same sound as a baby grand piano. It is created upright to save the space. However, if you notice that upright design, while very beautiful, very inconvenient. Anytime this instrument is played, or pretty much every few hours, has to be tuned. If you ever tuned a piano, nobody wants to do that. However, if you do not tune it, all that beautiful fabric right there, it's destroyed when the strings burst. So to save this instrument from itself, the dames have the strings cut. However, people still insist that they can hear music coming from that instrument. Wafting through the halls, they come in, they compliment us on the music. Very impossible because the strings are cut, so there is no music coming from that instrument. As a matter of fact, if any of you hear any music coming from that instrument, I will meet you on the trolley because I'm not staying here. All right, guys, now as she told you, there's a lot of residual and intelligent haunting in this house. There's also a lot of scents picked up. Now, when we go up the grand staircase to go upstairs in a little while, I want everybody to make sure that you're sniffing the air. Sounds a little crazy, but a lot of times people will be going up, you'll feel somebody come past you, brushing past you like with a long skirt. Often followed by the smell of floral, rosy perfume. So just keep that in mind when we get up the stairs.
All right. Has all this stuff been here for
her? It's all original.
Yep.
To the study of the Andrew Lowe home, or the library. Or when Andrew Lowe was in Savannah, this was his home office. However, we did talk about outside how he did not like to be in Savannah very often. He found it very depressing. And as a matter of fact, when his first wife passed away, he wouldn't use the parlor over there at all in any fashion. And that was fairly easy to do because, as many of you may have noticed, combining this room and the dining room is this beautiful butler's pantry right here. Come here, you guys can look at it. Now these steps here, they lead up to the bedrooms. These steps here, they lead down to where the original kitchen and servants' quarters was. Alright. He's not scary, don't worry. Now, down there is now archives, the offices. The story here is that the director of the Andrew Lowe staff was here very early in the morning. He was down there in the office. He was down there with another lady. They were waiting for two members of the society to come here very early in the morning. Now he's down there, and if you notice the acoustics in this house, they're incredible. He heard the door open. If he heard the door open, that side door opened. He also began to hear talking coming up the stairs behind him. He thinks it's the dames coming in. Now, they're not supposed to be here until later, but he's like, I need to talk to them anyway. He goes to find them. He follows them talking up these stairs. He follows it all around this floor. He cannot find them. He gets closer back to the pantry again. He begins to go up the stairs. It is always ahead of him out of sight, but he can never catch up to it. He gets followed talking up the stairs. He continues to do it. Eventually, the talking stops. Now, he's really puzzled because he knows he was following somebody around. Comes back down the stairs again, talks to the lady that's down there waiting with him. Says, I can't find anybody. She goes, well, nobody came in or out the whole time you were up there looking around. And when the members of the society came in later on, they actually confirmed him. They said, nope, we were nowhere near this house at any point during that night. So we don't know who he was chasing around. Alright,
is this a painting of Andrew Lowe up here?
No. Actually, Andrew Lowe was in the parlor.
Oh, okay. It's awful dark down there. Can't see nothing. Oops.
Right,
go ahead.
See, it's the most elegantly decorated of the entire bottom floor. Now, there's a lot of residual intelligent haunting that takes place here. A lot of sense again. Now, does anybody know what you would use a formal dining room like this after the meal was served when Andrew Lowe would live here? Nope, this is where the men would come in after the meals. They would come in, they would talk to each other, entertain each other, smoke their cigars. If you've ever smelled a cigar, it's a very distinctive smell. Carpets have been treated, walls have been cleaned, people still insist that they smell cigar smoke. Had a whole tour last week, split in half just like you. Both groups, when we got back on the trolley, they told me they smelled cigar smoke. The lowest member we talk about, the offices and the archives, there's a huge desk down there. It's original to the house, very heavy. Two accountants were down there, working, crunching the numbers from the week before. They both saw something out of the corner of their eye. A set of filing cards that was on a file cabinet down there, picked up, floated to the middle of the room, and then just dropped. You can imagine, they booked it, they got out of there. All right, guys. When they come down, when we go up, that's where everybody has died, right upstairs, okay?
All I did was, Melissa, the only time I played.
I see pictures of the mirrors like I told you. That is the mirror where her face got caught last week as well. I think she was doing like a quick video and the face just popped in and popped right back out. So, are you okay? You're good, right? I told you were great. Alright guys, as soon as they come down, we go up. Are you ready? Alright, here we go.
Now you can go ahead. I want to try and get that. I want to get that after you get it. How about you wear a statue?
Sometimes.
You guys waiting or?
Yeah, she needed a break.
Oh, okay.
Scariest part of this home. Now, we're only really going to be talking about two rooms, these two rooms right here. This room right over here, with all these ladies are standing in front of, that is the low bedroom. Now, a lot of women in this family, they are very drawn to that room. Because a lot of women in this family are drawn to that room, that is where a lot of women in this family have died. Mary Kustos did pass away in that room, as did Juliet Gordon Lowe. She died at the window looking down at Savannah. Now, that's why we think there's a lot of sadness that emits from it sometimes. Not all the time, only when the situations really call for it. But when they do, it's like hitting a brick wall. Now, in 1979, we had a huge storm that ripped through Savannah. It bordered on a hurricane. After the storm had passed, two dames came through the home to investigate, make sure the house was still standing, open up the windows, things like that. Now, the thing you have to remember about the dames, they do not believe in ghosts. However, when they're downstairs investigating, they hear soft crying. The crying continues the whole time. They come up to the landing here, it becomes sobbing. They get to the low bedroom, it is wailing. They are absolutely certain somebody else is in this home, but upon investigation, nobody is here. That wailing in that room does not stop, though. It reaches a finger pitch. It continues the whole time that they are in this home. Eventually, they can't.
Yeah, I don't know if I'm going to get on this. It's so dark.
They have to leave. A few weeks passed. We're assured the house has withstood the storm. We also realized the day they heard all that crying over there, that was June 17th. June 17th is the anniversary of the day that Mary Cooper Stiles passed away. It's also the day us here at Ghost and Gravestones, we all try to get a day off of our vacation. Nobody wants to be here. All right, guys, this room right here, the Eliza Stiles room, is my favorite room. Look at that wallpaper. Now, Eliza Stiles is married to her stepmother. She did come here to stay in this house and help with the children after her daughter passed away. That's why it is right across from the nursery. We call it the Eliza Stiles room. We don't think that's her in there. William Henry Stiles, her husband, Rachel Stiles' father, a retired colonel from the Civil War, contracted an illness, came to this home to be with his wife and recuperate. However, if you guys know anything about pneumonia during that time frame, the prognosis was not good. He did pass away in that room. Now we got our lady housekeeping staff. She started cleaning very, very early in the morning. She was starting in the basement, come all the way up here. Every single day when she was cleaning this floor, she saw a man rocking in that rocking chair. She saw him so often, she started addressing him. She would call him Mr. Lowe. She would say, "Hello, Mr. Lowe. Good morning, Mr. Lowe." There's a picture of Andrew Lowe downstairs. She admitted it does not even look like him. This man she sees in the rocking chair, he is a gaunt.
Do what?
He is an older man.
I think I see something in the window.
As we know that William himself was an older man when he came here.
Oh, yeah.
He was a sickly man. We believe that's him that she's seeing over there.
Looks like a face, doesn't it?
Over and over again. You guys can go around and take a lot of pictures. Did anybody have to notice the picture in this one? That's sitting on the mantle over there. I wonder if anybody knows who he is.
Yeah, picture of the
chairman. Did you see that? You recognize him? Nope. That is Robert E. Lee, guys. Last week, or two weeks ago, I had a tour. And I was telling the stories like I was doing up here with you guys. I told them I'll take pictures. I had a girl come over here, took me a picture of that doll. She screamed no. Screams again. Storms downstairs. She scared
the window where the chair is. It's gone now.
They go back downstairs. I said, "What happened when we got there?"
There was a face in that window earlier. Me and her saw it. We saw it together. There was a face in that window. I don't know what. What's it look like to you?
Yeah, I thought I was trying to blow it up and see.
I don't know. I got it zoomed in, but I don't know if it's picking it up or not.
That's a cool little tool.
Yeah, GoPro.
Oh, I heard of those.
Yeah. Making it okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Are you my last little straggler?
Yeah. Yep. Aren't they adorable? We saved the best for last.
She's a little slow. She got a bad knee.
No worries. Take your time. Don't worry. The next stop, there are no steps.
That's a neat steeple.
They thought they saw the person outside.
They might have, because
because, like I said, it's been very extra active all week long. I don't know if it's because of Halloween.
Oh, it's a church.
Extra.